Welcome to the cab familiarization video for the Komatsu PC2000-11 mining shovel excavator. The operator's cab of the new PC2000-11 is a spacious work environment, providing comfort and functionality. The operator has high visibility of the job site and gets the job done efficiently. Let's get familiar with the features inside the operator's cab. Notice that there are two monitors available to the operator. The upper ComVision monitor provides a 360-degree bird's-eye view of the worksite around the machine. It is touchscreen controlled for ease of operation. The lower high-resolution machine monitor provides state-of-the-art operator control over the machine operations. We will discuss the monitor operation in greater detail with different videos that follow this one. The adjustable air ride seat allows the operator to position himself for comfortable actuation of the function control levers. The control levers for travel can be actuated by hand or by foot. There is a convenient switch to turn on a seat heater. A second seat is available for use by a training instructor. Komatsu excavators are equipped with a lock lever that disconnects the control levers whenever the lock lever is down. This prevents accidental actuation of a machine function while entering or exiting the seat. The operator should only raise the lock lever while seated and prepared to operate the machine. The horn switch is installed on the right control lever. Warning lamps flash to provide visual notification in case the truck driver doesn't hear the horn sounding. The ignition key switch and throttle potentiometer are located on the right console. Switches are located on the left control lever to count two different trucks being loaded. The left side lever stand is also the location for the radio and auxiliary port for your iPod or MP3 player. Beyond the left lever stand is the console where two air conditioning panels are located. Combined airflow from two AC units ensures operator comfort in the hottest of weather. Continuing along the console, we see a 24-volt cigarette lighter and two 12-volt power supplies. Next to the power supplies is a LAN connector for downloading COM tracks plus data to your laptop computer. Push the emergency engine stop switch and its indicator lamp will illuminate green. Twisting the stop switch in a clockwise direction will re-enable normal engine operation and the indicator lamp will stop illuminating. Now let's look at the switches that engage various functions of the machine. An on-off switch is available if the machine has been equipped with optional beacons mounted to the operator's cab and power module. The auxiliary lamp switch will illuminate work lights on the sides and rear of the machine. The working lamp switch illuminates lights around the machine to brighten the work site during nighttime operations. This switch will also illuminate the monitor screen day and night. The staircase light switch will activate lamps that illuminate the walkways leading to the operator's cab. The lamps will continue illuminating for 90 seconds after releasing the switch, even if the ignition key switch is off. The room lamp switch will illuminate the light that brightens the operator cab compartment. The swing lock switch will engage the swing brake, overriding the normal brake release function. This prevents the revolving frame from swinging. Do not use this switch to stop a swinging machine. When the boom shock absorbing switch is engaged, the boom comes to a smoother stop. This adds to operator comfort. The boom may continue to move slightly after the operator has released the control lever. When the switch is disengaged, the feel of the boom stopping will return to normal. The machine push-up switch changes the digging force exerted by the boom. When the switch is in the high pressure mode, maximum digging force is available. The low pressure mode makes scraping and cleanup operations easier because the boom resistive force will yield with less effort. The grease mode selector switch is set to the auto mode, enabling computer-controlled greasing of the machine. The switch should be set to the auto mode for normal machine operation. Set the switch to manual mode to use the grease gun, to test the system, or to bleed air from the system. The service center switch is located inside the operator's cab. The service center should remain stowed and locked while the machine is in operation. Unlocking the system allows the service center to be lowered into position using separate controls. These separate controls will also be used to raise the service center back to its stowed position. Lock the system when the service center is fully raised and stowed. Notice the two sunlight sensors that help the air conditioning system regulate temperature inside the operator's cab. A secondary engine stop switch is located below the machine near the operator's left foot. It is used to shut down the engine if the ignition key switch fails to stop the engine. Lift the cover, enclosing the switch, then flip the switch up to stop the engine. Closing the cover will return the switch to its normal position. Notice the small hammer installed nearby. Use this hammer to break the window for an emergency exit if the door is jammed shut. This concludes the cab familiarization video for the Komatsu PC2000-11 mining shovel excavator. For additional information, please reference the operation and maintenance manual or contact your local distributor. You may also visit us at www.komatsuamerica.com. Thank you for choosing Komatsu products.